Welcome students, this is a continuation of measurement chapter. In the previous class we have learnt about volume of regular objects using formulas. So regular objects like cube, cuboid, sphere, cylinder, using certain formulas we can find their volume. Now we are going to learn how to find the volume of irregularly shaped objects. So irregularly shaped objects are stones. So here we are going to do an activity because there are no formula to determine the volume of irregularly shaped objects like stone. So for such cases their volume can be determined using a measuring cylinder and water. So for this activity we need a measuring cylinder, water, stone and a thread. So take a measuring cylinder and pour some water into it. So this is the measuring cylinder. We have to pour some water into it, but do not fill the cylinder completely because the maximum capacity of this container is 50. So we have to take up to 30 or 40. So note down the volume of water from the readings of the measuring cylinder. So here the volume of the measuring cylinder is 30. So that is V1, that is the volume of water, take it as V1. Then next, now take a small stone and tie it with a thread. So this is the stone, we are going to find the volume of this stone only. So we have to take this stone and tie it with a thread. Then immerse the stone inside the water by holding the thread like this. So now the level of water has raised. So see, before immersing the stone, the level of water is 30. After immersed the stone, the level of water is 40. So note down the volume of water. So this is V2. Here the V2 is 40 ml. So the volume of the stone is equal to the volume of the water. So see here, V1 is 30, V2 is 40. So before immersing the stone, the level of water is 30. After immersed the stone, the level of water is 40. So V1, V2, we know. So from this volume of stone, V2 minus V1, that is 40 minus 30, 10. So 10 is the volume of stone. So this is the volume of stone. So next, so let us summarize volume of regular and irregular objects. So volume of regular objects, cube, cuboid, sphere, cylinder, we can find using certain formulas. For cube, side into side into side. For cuboid, length into breadth into height. Then for sphere, 4π/3πr³. Then for cylinder, πr²h. So in irregular objects, we don't have certain formulas to find their volume. So we are using measuring cylinder and water to find their volume. So students, hope you all understand. Let us learn about density in the next class. Thank you.